for our network. So what does the Kava network enable generally when we think about Cosmos and Ethereum? So what are the benefits of them too? I'm highlighting three that we emphasize and work very closely on. Seamless interoperability. So these two together, the Ethereum and Cosmos co-chains, interoperate seamlessly with each other. They empower developers to build in whichever environment they'd like without sacrificing any access to users or assets or anything of that nature. Optimized scalability. So it's very unique for our platform, for our network, that we have this unique architecture that enables the free flow of users, assets, and projects between Kava and the various ecosystems at scale. And the last point here is that rapid ecosystem growth. This type of interaction enables us to grow rapidly across both ecosystems, the Ethereum and the Cosmos, because you're able to reach the majority of the population that either prefer one versus the other, and the assets that flow in one and not the other, enabling them to flow together. So speaking of enhancing the ecosystem growth and rapidly growing, one of the things that we have is our coverized program. So when we think about us focusing on rewarding the creators for a thriving ecosystem, this is why Kava developed the coverized program. It's an easy three-step program to get developers to launch on our Kava platform. So protocols that are most important to, they are the most important for a driver for value in the Web3 world. This program rewards top projects on the Kava network with $750 million in developer incentives awarded to them transparently on-chain based on usage. So this is something that we're very proud of and we're very happy to have, and our partners and ecosystem projects are very excited about. If you'd like to learn more about how to build and some of the items and the benefits and how to get started, you can get into our docs from here. This is a links docs.kava.io, and that will help you understand the benefits and how to get started and to submit your project if you have one that you'd like to get started with. All right, so with the launch of Kava EVM last year, builders have come to Kava and usage generally on chain has been increasing significantly. There's exposure to ecosystem adoption. There's been stable developments in the infrastructure scaling from a software and node performance standpoint, and additional developer resources to make it easier to build, flourish on the Kava EVM. With that, one of the most exciting things that we're experiencing that right now is that we were able to deploy USDT on Kava. So this is native USDT that is launched on our network. And this integration has been extremely important, and we're very, very happy that we were able to win Tether's trust and them choosing us to be the one that is able to distribute USDT across the Cosmos side of the world. This is a game changer for the Cosmos ecosystem, and it positions us as a leading hub for USDT transactions across the interchain. So this integration brings stability and unlocks liquidity across the Cosmos and Kava EVM ecosystems, and this solves fragmented liquidity. Right now, USDT is the native stable coin that will be available on the Cosmos side, which is very exciting. Native USDT issued on Kava will power a robust DeFi economy and empower users, DApp partners, and native projects with a secure and widely adopted canonical stablecoin. So we're very happy about this launch and very excited about what's to come next for it. I spoke a little bit about why is this integration so important. This integration offers secure, battle-tested platform for transactions, investments, and DeFi activities. they users can confidently manage crypto with native USDT issued on Kava. And Tether provides a fully transparent, best-in-class asset management, backing USDT with the most secure liquid reserves on the market. So we're very excited about this integration. So now if you're thinking, great, I'm a user, I would like to explore the different ways that I can interact with assets within the ecosystem. I'm going to use USDT as one example of how you can interact with our ecosystem and what you can do in order for you to start experimenting and deep diving into that. The example I'm going to use here is USDT. So the question is, where do I get USDT and how do I use it, generally speaking? So there are different exchanges that you're able to get USDT from. And there are also Axelar Squid one-click router. I know that you guys had Axelar join you in the previous conversations. So we're very happy to have them support this for us. And then I'll share a video of how that works, as well as you're able to access USDT via curve pools. So I'll also show a video of that. Let's take a look at how using Axelar enables users to get USDT from the EVM side of the world to the US to Cosmos side of the world on Kava. And then from our perspective, within the Kava ecosystem, we're able to take USDT and then do an IBC transfer into various Cosmos chains. So this is a huge launch for us. This is very exciting for us, and we're very happy to be able to provide that service to the various Cosmos chains. So let's take a quick look at this example. I think I have it open here. We can get started. I had it recorded just so I have it ready. So you select your network, you select your asset, you want to get your USDT, you want to select your Kava chain. And from there, once you get your USDT asset, you're able with one click to be able to submit that transaction. And this is very exciting because users didn't have that power in the past to be able to take it from the Ethereum side of the world and be able to bring it to a network that's going to be able to send it to various Cosmos ecosystem projects. And just like that, users are able to get their USDT to where they want it to be. Another example for as a use case that users are able to go through Curve. It depends on your familiarity with Curve. You're able to select a pool within the Kava network. And then there you select your Axel USDT, USDT pool, for example. And then you're able to swap, if you'd like, your assets, or you're able to deposit them, of course. But this enables you to get more liquidity and then start exploring different use cases within USDT. I'm going to talk about the surge event in a second. I'm going to look at one of our ecosystem projects. For example, here is Mare. This project is built on the Kava network. However, it supports EVM assets, so assets that are not native IBC assets, that are not Cosmos assets, which means it's not very common for us to see Atom on the list of assets, but they were able to do so using our IBC transfer, using the ability of providing that service to them. And that is done through our transfer process. So you're able to go here into our app, for example, and take an asset, which is Atom in this scenario. You connect your EVM wallet, your Cosmos wallet. In this scenario, let's connect Kepler. And then you can connect your MetaMask wallet, and then you can make that transfer. So what's happening here is I'm taking Adam from the Cosmos side and bringing it to the EVM side of the world. So this is giving the Cosmos side of the world assets the ability to be used and leveraged across projects and dApps and access to users who are used to using the EVM side of the world, which is very exciting. It's never been done before, and that's a huge win for the Cosmos side of the world. So any of these assets, you can launch them into these apps where users that haven't interacted with Cosmos assets are able to interact with Cosmos assets. It's very exciting for us. One of the things that we're doing to highlight the success of this USDT launch is that we are doing a triple surge event, which means that we're adding rewards and incentives for our the various products that and use cases for USDT. This event starts next week, and we're very excited about that. Some of the products and the use cases we're highlighting in this campaign is Curve, and the Curve. This is a link for it. Mare, the product I just looked at, and that's the link for it. So it's a lending platform. And then the Kava Lend, which is also a lending platform. And the surge event happens next week. So stay tuned. Follow us on Kava Chain on Twitter. You'll be able to learn more about when it's happening and get first access to it. All right, so let's talk a little bit about the road ahead. What are some of the things that we are thinking through as we think about the road ahead for us? And let me just make sure I go to slideshow. All right, we have three pillars that we're focused on. These three pillars are adoption, security, and governance. What adoption really means is that the ability for us to grow our ecosystem and have users from across both the Cosmos side and the EVM side join us and be able to experience the benefits of both sides of the world. So to highlight, we are driving a lot of innovative products to join the Kava network and different very successful project teams are very interested, and they're able to build great experiences on the Kava block, Kava network on the EVM side. So our focus is to grow that at the moment and increase user adoption and give access to a lot of the assets that were not available for both the Cosmos side and the EVM side. So that's very exciting for us. This adoption requires significant work on the protocol side of the house, but also in various relationship and partnerships with not only projects that are building within the Kava network, but also our chains. So it's been exciting to work closely with other chains on the Cosmos side and on the EVM side. So working with and understanding their needs when it comes to getting USDT to that side of the world, to the Cosmos side of the world. What does that really look like, and what is the process in order for us to do so? And building that within our application to enable users to do that it takes a lot of effort, and we're very excited to have that ability for users to go from one to the other in a seamless experience that doesn't require them to go to multiple places. They're just doing it in one click and reap the benefits from there. These are the main focus of the items that we're gonna talk about. And then one of the things that we wanted to surface and highlight is the Kinetics-based project that is launching very, very soon for us. Quick Swap team chose Kava to build this native project because they believe in Kava's positioning of connectivity of Cosmos and Ethereum. So we're very excited about this launch. This will happen in mid-August. With this launch, we'll also have various activities and promotions that will help drive adoption and excitement around this specific project. It will have a lot of high performance perpetual exchange There's going to be lots of asset diversity in it, great user experience. It's similar to a GMX project, if you guys have experienced that in the past or have used that in the past. And then the second part of that launch is the Uniswap V3 DEX, it has active liquidity management. Right now, we're very excited about working with this team. We're very excited they were able to choose Kava for it. And we're happy about all the things to come. What's happening in the next few weeks as well is that mid-August, we will have our internal transfer ready, where users are going to directly be able to take USDT from the Kava ecosystem and send it to any of the applications that support USDT on the Kava side, on the Kava side of the world, which will open a lot of liquidity opportunities, a lot of excitement around that. And that Cosmos side have never seen that. So that is happening in mid-August, as well as the Kinetics launch. And we also have another exciting project from the Banky team that's launching in September. So we have a lot of new and innovative things that are happening. We're finalizing our roadmap for Kava 15, which will have lots of exciting updates as well. So stay tuned for that. With this, I think this is all the content I had for today's session. Do you guys have any questions for me? Can you still hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you.
Fantastic. Do you guys have any questions for me?
Oh, any questions? Do you have finished your sharing, Amir?
I'm sorry?
Do you have finished your sharing?
Do I have any? Yes, I have. I've shared all my slides.
Oh, okay. Okay, I just ask the other audience. Hello, everyone. Do you have any questions about this speech in Kamir?
So if I see questions around security.
Okay.
I see about the issue with multi-chain. The issue with multi-chain is very unfortunate, and we were all in disbelief that this happened, and we wish that it was never the case for any of the users who participated in this. From our perspective, we've tried to reach out to the multi-chain team. We continuously offered to our resources to help in any way, shape, or form to be able to debug any issues they were running into when they experienced the router issues. And unfortunately, that wasn't the case. And we're unable to see what is the latest there with their assets at the moment. And it's not something that we're taking lightly. We've been very cautious about how we issue some of the assets, and this is why the native USDT is the place for us to be, and that's it's a better alternative for the users. There's nothing that's no risk, right? We're in the space that that there's a lot of bets that users can take on. However, with native USDT, it's a more stable alternative than dealing with various bridged assets and the securities that come with that.
Okay, thanks, Kamir. One of the audience have a question, and I say to you, Kava is undoubtedly a successful cross-chain project. And can you share some operational and the management experience, Karmel?
Can I share what exactly?
Management experience in Kava.
A management experience in Kava?
Yeah.
Yeah. We have a fantastic team, and we continuously iterate and innovate together, and we're a very close group of individuals, and we value the user experience. We value offering value to our users, and making sure that we're building thoughtful products and experiences. If anyone is interested in any of the positions that we have open, I'm happy to share and help them. However, generally speaking, in the role of product and building product management generally, it's something that is exciting for me to be a part of. I'm just reading the comments.
Can you share? Okay. Yes. Okay. Can you see the
yep.
Sentence? I sent on the chat box. Okay.
Yes.
What is the role?
Yeah, so Kava's native token is basically the token that's used for native governance, and it's also our staking token. This enables its decentralization and security. So Kava, this is the native governance token that's generally used, and it's our staking token. If you're able to experiment with it or join the network, you'll be able to stake it, but it's also the governance token where you can vote on specific things.
Okay, and I have another, maybe
yes.
The last question.
Of course.
Okay. How users can participate in Kava's upcoming
multiple USDTs and NFTs.
Yeah.
Yes. I can go ahead and share my screen. 1 second.
Oh, no.
You should be able to see my screen now.
Okay.
So with the multi USDT, it's a triple USDT event. This is what it's called. It's a triple surge event. And this will be available on Curve.
Mm-hmm.
Users can directly go to this Curve pool. The link is right here.
Mm-hmm.
And they'll be able to participate as they would like. Mm-hmm. Same with Mare Finance. It's another use case. You're going to be able to visit the product and be able to supply, borrow. It's a lending platform, so be able to explore the different functionalities and benefits of that. And the last option is Kava Lend, where users can also supply and participate in the EVM side of the Kava Lend protocol. And these are the three use cases that will be applied for the Triple Surge event. And this event will begin next week. TBD on the dates. We'd like you to follow us on Kava Chain, and we'll announce it there. We'll have lots of exciting news that we'll push for it there as well. And that's that.
Okay, and we have maybe this is the last question.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, I have said it. How is Kava's performance and scalability? How does it handle high throughput and large scale transactions?
Yes, this is actually a very good question, because especially with more and more usage coming on chain, for us, especially from the EVM side, our team has been working very, very hard to have lots of updates in our infrastructure scaling, mainly focusing on node performance and making sure that have additional developer resources and applying them to ensure that there is lots of support for developers as they're building, and then also being able to have really stable node performance that can scale to others. And we continuously work with our various ecosystem partners and developers generally, and continuously seek their feedback and work closely to them to make sure that they have the experience that they would like and the experience that we would like to offer them, and strive to make sure that it's a powerful experience.
Okay, thanks, Camille. These are all the questions, and thanks for your fantastic and amazing sharing and speech. And this is the end. See you, Camille, and see you, other audience. Let's see the next week. Okay, see you.
Thank you so much. Have a wonderful day. Appreciate you having us. Appreciate it. Bye-bye.
Oh, see you. Bye-bye.